He said, I couldn't breathe. I know I'm close to death. Chilling testimony today from the police officer shot and paralyzed after responding to a home invasion call. Good evening, everyone. I'm Wendy Bell.
I'm Andrew Stocky. A difficult day on the stand for Officer James Kuzak. Marcy Cipriani was in court. She's live downtown now with more. Marcy?
Well, Andrew, I spoke with Officer James Kuzak just outside the courtroom, and he was actually in very good spirits, despite a pretty emotional day. The chaos, confusion, and violence of that April day, many of us have seen in pictures. But the reality of those moments became clear through Officer James Kuzak's words to the jury. Realizing the second he was shot, standing on the back porch of this Clairton home, Officer Kuzak testified, "It's becoming harder to breathe. I can't scream for help. I'm close to death." Officer Kuzak told the jury, "That's when people in your life flash before your eyes." On the stand, the impact this shooting has had on Officer Kuzak is easy to see. Emotionally, he needs breaks in his testimony. And physically, it's difficult to miss that the shooting has him confined to a wheelchair. But he continues, remembering lying on the ground, shot and unable to move. "I can't feel my legs. I see the legs of a person coming over my legs. In my mind, I think this is the person who shot me." Officer Kuzak says he closed his eyes, lying there helpless in the dark. He told the jury, "I'm preparing to die. I'm thinking they're going to finish me off, so I turn away, thinking they're going to shoot me in the head, but nothing happened." Officer Kuzak's girlfriend, parents, and two of the jurors cried through his words, words the defense admits were tough for them, too.
"And I feel terrible for him. People have to understand we're just doing our job. We still have feelings. We're still human. I feel that it was absolutely terrible what happened to him, and our hearts go out to him and wish him the best."
But it wasn't your client.
It wasn't my client who did it.
Both men charged claim they are innocent, and they sat through the tears and testimony quietly, listening, and unemotional as Officer James Kuzak relived that day that changed his life. Since Officer Kuzak could be called back to the stand, he remained sequestered and was not able to hear the testimony of a fellow officer who actually ran to his aid. I was inside the courtroom for that testimony, and I'll have that for you new at 6. Live downtown, Marcy Cipriani, Channel 4 Action News.